In this video, we take a look at how to create a Christmas carol flyer like this in Photoshop, and this is coming up. Hey everybody, it's Innocent here, and welcome to the channel once again. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you're new here, please hit on the subscribe button. If you're old here, thank you so much for showing up. So a link to download all the resources that I'll be using in this video will be linked up in the description. Do check it out, download, practice, and send it to me on IG. Let's get interacted. Now let's get into Photoshop and let's get started. So we are basically going to do this for social media, or preferably Instagram. So we're going to create a new document for Instagram, and I'm using Photoshop CS6, but this should work for even the latest version of Photoshop. So let's go to File and then New, and then we can create an 8 by 8 inches. You can basically create like 4 by 4, but 8 by 8 inches works so fine for me, and I can go ahead and click OK. Now the first thing that we want to do is to build up our background, and we've got a lot of things to help us do that here. The first one would have to be the background. So this is the background that we're going to use, and I'm going to drag and drop it inside of Photoshop, and I'll leave it over here. So you take your time to resize it, and then you can press on enter to set your background. Now this background is already set up, so what we're going to do is we go into our resource again, and we have this tube as another set of backgrounds. So I'm going to use this particular one, but I got two for you. You can use that when you are practicing. So I'll drag and drop this also inside of Photoshop, and I'm going to scale it to fill the entire canvas like this. So let me try and bring it down like that. We're going to place something on top here, so the top isn't that much of a problem. Now we're going to right click, rasterize the layer, and we're going to press Ctrl Shift and then U to desaturate it. Afterwards, we go to the blending mode, and then we're going to set this to soft light, so it blends seamlessly with the background. If it feels like it's too much for you, you can use the opacity to reduce it, something like this. So we can go for about 70, or let's say 80%, or even you can maintain the 100%. Let's maintain that. Okay, so these two are pretty much going to be the background, just the background. But we have a couple of elements that I got from here, the Christmas leaves, the Christmas ball, and all those elements. So we're going to add those elements to the design. The first one that we add is the Christmas leaf here, and I'm going to bring it inside of Photoshop. So that is going to be the one to be on top here. So I'm going to open it up like this to fill the very upper part of the design. So something pretty simple like that. Now we want this element to blend with the background, because we are going for this gold theme sort of color or sort of theme. So we want this to blend with the background. So in order to do that, what we're going to do is we're going to rasterize this layer. So you right click on it and you rasterize it, and we want to get this to this particular color, something quite similar to this particular color. So it is going to go from the greens to this sort of gold color. So we're going to make use of the hue and saturation. You press Ctrl U, and then the hue and saturation is going to pop up. Now with the first line here, the hue and saturation, when you drag it to either of the side, it is going to give you a different kind of color. So I'm going to drag it to the extreme left, that is to the negative side of things, and we drag it to this side till we have something quite similar to this. So I think this works well for us. Let me go for about 60. Okay, so this works quite, or let me try and go for, what do you think? So around 60, I think this works so fine for us. So we try to get this whole thing in the same kind of theme. And the next thing we bring in is another sort of Christmas tree. So this one too, we bring it inside of Photoshop. So this is going to be the element, and we're going to transform it out, rotate it like that. Now we can send it to the extreme left here. Let's place it somewhere around here, and let's try to close it up a little bit like that, and it will show up over here. So once that is done, we're going to right click on that one also, go to the rasterized layer, press Ctrl U, and we do the same thing for this one as well. So we're going to try to get this sort of color, something right over there, and then you click OK. You can take your time to reposition it like that. Now, when you go back to the resource, we have another set of elements over here, and we're going to drag that also into Photoshop. So we bring one here, and we want that to be underneath of this Christmas leaf, because when you position it here, the bar shouldn't show up there. So we want to drag it underneath of the Christmas leaf here, and we can position that one over there. Now we want to get this particular color to also suit this one, so we right click, rasterize, and then we use the hue and saturation, and then we can saturate it a bit. But this time, instead of going to the extreme left, we decide to go to the extreme right, so as to get this sort of thing to fit the background that we are using. And then when you are done, you click OK. So right from there, we can make duplicate and then use this to decorate our background. So what we do is we press Ctrl J to make a duplicate. We can send this one right over here, and then we can select the two of them, push them up a little bit like that, or perhaps you can go for this particular one. You right click and then you can select this one and drag it to the very bottom like this, and we get back to the Christmas element, and we can make more duplicates to decorate our background. So we press Ctrl J to duplicate that one again, and we drag it to this very side. Can press Ctrl T to transform it to be a bit smaller like that, and then you can take your time to position it over here. Now you make one more duplicate, and then you can send that also over here. The last element that we want to bring to board is the Christmas snowball, so we're going to drag and drop that also inside of Photoshop. And all these elements that I'm using are basically PNG, so you don't really need to do anything. You just have to be dropping and dragging and dropping them inside of Photoshop. So with this one, we don't need to do anything because it already has the theme that we are looking for. So you press Ctrl J to make another duplicate. You can send it to this very part, press Ctrl T to transform it, right click, and then you can flip it horizontal, so you can take your time to position it right over here. Now on top of these two elements over here, these two Christmas elements, you want to create a sort of light, a very sharp light on it. So on top of that, you're going to create a new layer on top here, and you're going to pick our brush tool. Now you make sure that your foreground color is set to white, and then your hardness is 0. Any other thing here should be 100%. Now you can increase it to the very size that you want. In my case, I wanted something pretty simple like this one, and then I can go ahead and make just one stroke of brush, so something like this one. So it makes this brush, and you go to the blending mode on the same layer, go to the blending mode, and then you can set this one to overlay, so it creates that sort of very nice lighting over there. If I make another stroke of brush, you see that it brightens the more. And then I can make a duplicate by pressing Ctrl J, and then I can send that one to over here, so it creates that sort of lighting for us. From here, the rest of the things that we're going to add will be text, so I can group all of these ones from this side, and then I can call it my elements. So elements over here, pretty simple. So we're going to add our text to this, and we'll be done with the design. So we're going to use just 3 fonts, and a link to download all the fonts will be in the description, so you can download them for free as well. So first of all, we're going for the text tool, and over here I have my text already written, so I am going to use the first font that I'm going to use is called ETH. So I'll leave a link in the description. So I go inside of the text that I've already written, and I can copy that of the church name, and then I can paste it right over here. I want to select all of it, and I want to center it like that, and I can press Ctrl T to transform it like this. Press Ctrl A and I can center it, quite simple like that. So the Methodist church, let me zoom in so that it will not appear that it is kind of very, very blurry. Now let me select all of this. It looks as if it is too closed up, so we're going to reduce the tracking here. Let's set it to about -40%, and then we are good to go. Or let's even come down a little bit, so -20 here, that will do. And then we can click OK. So we go ahead, and then we can take another test. So let's go for the test tool, and the next test that we're going to use is called Trajan Pro. I'll leave links in the description. For that one, we're going to use the bold version, and then we can go and copy the 9 lesson and carol. So 9 lesson, and we copy that and then we can paste it. So we can press Control T over here and we can increase it out a bit bigger like this. We press Control A and then you can center it like that. Now let me push it up a little bit to this very side over here. And then I can right click on this one, go to the blending options. I want to add a couple of effects to it. So the first one will be the gradient overlay. So my gradient overlay, I'll choose this particular gradient that I've already set up. So this is the gradient. These are the coordinates if you want to use it. And this is the second one right over there. So if you want to copy and use the same thing, you are good to use it. After I'm done, I'll click OK. I'll come to the angle here and then I'm going to set that to 0%, and then that will be it for the gradient. Now I'll go to the auto glow and then I'm going to add a bit of auto glow to it. So first off, I'll increase the size and I'll increase the spread a little bit so that it can pop out, and I'm going to choose a color from this very side. So it doesn't have to be that very whitish, but kind of yellowish sort of. And then when I'm done with everything, I'll go ahead and then I'll click OK, and I can transform this one out a little bit like that. So once I'm done with this, I would want to select all my text again and go back to my toggle character and give this one -100 because I want it to be very, very closed up, not as compared to the first one that we did here. So once that is done, we're just going to make a duplicate by pressing Ctrl J, and then you can send it to the very down here. We can edit this one to carols, so 9 lessons and carols, and then we can press Ctrl T, transform this one to be quite bigger than the 9 lessons, and then we can bring it over here, so 9 lessons and carols. Let me make it some quite bigger like that. So for this one, we want to add one more effect to it. So let's go back to the blending options, and then we're going to add a bevel and emboss to it. So the first one that we're going to set is we're going to increase the size to 10, and then we jump straight to the gloss contour here. You left click on this arrow and then you can pick any one of these, any one that works best for you, but this one worked so well for me, so I just picked that one and then I can click OK. So you can take your time to position this one. Make sure that there is a bit of space between these two. So inside this very O here, we want to add another set of ellipse to it. So let's pick the ellipse tool and then we can create a very small ellipse over there like that. And then I can position it over here. You take your time to do that. You can double click on the layer thumbnail here, and then you can change the color from this very side. So something like that, and you click OK. Now the last thing that we want to add will be the date, the time, and then the venue. And for that, I'm going to use the font Poppins. So I've already got the text set, so I have Poppins over here, and I'm going into my text and I can copy and paste that one. So you copy this first one and then you can paste it here. I don't want this one to be bold, so let's go for medium or perhaps semi-bold. And then we can set this one to left align like that. And this is the color that I'm using in case you want to know that as well. So you go ahead and click OK, and then you can position this one right over here. So we can bring in a ruler, something like that. And then you're going to make a duplicate. So you press Ctrl J to make a duplicate, and then you can bring it over here. Now let's go into our test, and then we can copy this one too. That is the venue. Select it all and we're going to paste that. Select all again and set it to left aligned, and then you can position that also right over there. Now we want to use these sort of rectangles to separate them. So let me add one rectangle here, so something like that. And we're going to use the same color that the test used. So let me zoom in them all like this. Press Ctrl T to bring it over here like that. And then I can double click on the layer thumbnail from this side and pick this particular color over here. So I can take my time to position it over here, and I'll make a duplicate and drag it to this very side. So I can push my time to this very side a little bit like that. And then from there, I can select all of these ones starting from the date, and I can group this to date, time, and then the venue, and try to position or open it up a little bit like that. And I can do the same thing for this one as well. I can group this and call that the name. Now, once we are done with this, it means that we can open this one up to be bigger like that. So we press Ctrl T to open it up so that the date, the time, and then the venue will be very big. And you can press Ctrl A to center it. Something quite simple like that. And the last thing we want to do is get back to the background here, right click and rasterize it, and we press Ctrl L to add a bit of levels to it so that it can blend all in with the colors that we've added so far. So something like this will be quite okay like that. And that is how you create a very simple carol service flyer, very simple one for Instagram or for social media handles. You can use the same approach to create it for print, that is if you want to use either A3 or A4 or even a banner. Now let me show you this quick trick that you can use to easily manipulate the color. So on top here, you can go ahead into the layer adjustments and you can add a hue and saturation over here, and you can change the color easily from this side. Isn't this so cool? So you can easily change it without having to go through all the colors and change it. So you can easily take time to explore. Let me know in the comment section which is your favorite color. This color is so nice for me. This particular color is so nice for me. And you can even slide it to the very right side here and you can have something like this. So you can manipulate it very easily, and then you can have different set of colors. And if you don't want it, you want to get back to your original sort of design, you just have to turn this one off and bingo, you have your original design. And that will be it for this video. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch this video. Do check out the other tutorials that I made last year. I made another carol service flyer and it was amazing. You can check that out. I'll leave links in the description. So yes, thank you so much for sticking around to watch. I'll see you guys in the next one. Merry Christmas in advance. It's Innocent here and bye.